I am H.C. Gera, special correspondent from the Voice of Chandigarh. Friends, I'll be speaking to Mr. Shuja Medhi. He is one of the stalwarts in Visit Britain, British Tourist Authority. We have just discussed a brief account about what the real role is being played by him. Welcome to the Voice of Chandigarh, sir.
Thank you for having me.
I am really glad to share with my viewers that Shuja Medhi, B2B Manager India, is doing a wonderful job for attracting the tourists in his country, that is in UK. What is your take on it at present? What the situation of the tourists coming to UK is there?
We are very, very happy with the growth that we're seeing from the Indian market, which is a major part in thanks to the Cricket World Cup, which is being held in the UK at the moment. We are seeing thousands and thousands of Indians traveling there to watch Team India play and support their team. I was personally there at one of the matches in India-Pakistan on the 16th of last month. It was an absolutely amazing experience.
What was the response when the matches were going on? You talked about it, and really, it was wonderful to hear from your mouth.
It is actually a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity if you get to watch what I believe is the biggest match in the world. India versus Pakistan at the World Cup. There is nothing bigger than that. The kind of feeling that you get when the national anthem is played on a foreign soil and you have 30,000 Indians singing the national anthem with you, it really swells you up with pride.
Emotional and connected with the country also.
Absolutely. What was even surprising for me is to see outside the stadium, there were over 10,000 people who had gathered. And they were just watching the match on screen outside the stadium because they couldn't get tickets. So I spoke to quite a few of them and I asked that you couldn't get ticket, but why are you here? They said just the atmosphere is so fantastic. When Team India will win and they will come out, for all of that to absorb the atmosphere we have come. And that shows you that cricket really is the true religion in India.
It's true, no doubt about it. Shuja, I am fascinated. One of the slogan you have written, I travel for culture. What is all about this?
This is part of our marketing campaign that we launched a couple of years ago. It basically highlights the reason as to why you are traveling to the UK. So for example, if you want to travel for culture, there are so many cultural attractions and so many experiences that you can immerse yourself in when you are there. The other reason we are asking, if you are traveling for great taste or food and drink, you will be surprised that there are more Indian restaurants in the UK than any other country in the world.
Somebody was telling me it is very expensive to visit UK. What is the situation as of now?
I don't think it is at all. If you plan your trip smartly, if you plan in advance, if you book in advance, it is easily comparable to any other country in Europe. So you can easily make up a package anywhere between 1,000 to 1,500 pounds if you sit with a good travel agent and if he has got good contracting. And that's part of my job.
Shuja, find your Great Britain is another one.
Yes.
Really fascinating point.
Yes.
Could you elaborate something about this?
Basically, everyone has reasons to travel to the UK. And we are asking the client who's traveling there that what are your reasons? And you should be able to find your Great Britain. For me, it was during that match of India-Pakistan when I was there.
Yes.
I raised a new slogan which said that Great Britain, great dreams come true. So that was my reason for traveling to the UK, which is under sport.
What will be your forthcoming role as B2B Manager India to promote tourism in UK?
We will be going ahead with a few commercial partnerships this year. We will be talking to our commercial partners. We will soon come out with more details. Under those partnerships, we will be advertising new itineraries for the UK, which even travel trade can buy, with direct consumers can buy with those trade travel companies. And you will be able to see a greater number of diversified itineraries. So not only London, but London plus places in the north of England like Manchester, Liverpool, Lake District, different kinds of itineraries. So not only your sightseeing tours, but actually self-drive itineraries also, which is something that is selling very big in India.
Shuja, I was having interaction with Samuel Amundsen yesterday and we had a great talk with him. The Voice of Chandigarh was also had a full interaction with him, and he said India and UK enjoy a kind of closer collaboration and it works as a bridge for the cultural exchange, for the bilateral trade also. What are your comments on it?
think in terms of links between two countries, India and UK, I don't think India has better links with any other country in the world.
Okay.
We have a history which spans over 250 years. And the High Commissioner here is working on a project which he calls the Living Bridge, because it's the people between the two countries which make this relationship so great. As Prime Minister Modi also acknowledges, the people-to-people contact between UK and India is amazing. Between the two countries, there are close to 1.3 million people traveling. So about 800,000 visitors from UK come to India every year. About 500,000 go from here to there. There are, in terms of connectivity, it is like no other. UK is the best connected long-haul destination to India in the world.
What will be your future strategy to draw more and more tourists?
I think our strategy would concentrate on access, for example, getting the visa services easy. We are working very closely with UKVI. Also, we'll be concentrating on encouraging more and more direct connectivity between India and the UK. So not only to London, but also to places like Manchester, to Edinburgh maybe. We'll also concentrate on product development with Travel Trade to get them to focus to sell more and more mono-Britain itineraries. So itineraries which have London and north of England and Scotland and even Wales as part of it, and not only make UK as part of their European departure, but sell it individually.
Thank you so much, Suja, for having a nice time and talking to the Voice of Chandigarh. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me.